Hi there, welcome back to the computer science series on logic gates. We'll be covering OR gate, AND gate, NOT gate, NOR gate, NAND gate, and SOR gate in this series. So let's start with OR gate. So if you look at this, this is the symbol representation of an OR gate. We have input A and input B on the left, and we have output on the right, which is stand for OUT. So in order for the output to be 1, either of the input must be 1. So let's look at the table itself. So look at this, when A and B are both 0, so the output X will be 0, and then 0, 1 is equal to 1, and then 1, 0 is equal to 1, and 1, 1 is equal to 1. So if you look at this table itself, when either of the input is 1, the output is always 1. And for AND gate, this is the simple representation of an AND gate, A, B, and output here. In order for the out to be 1, both A and B must be 1. So it means that both inputs must be 1. So let's look at the table itself. So if we have 0, 0 here is equal to 0, and then 0, 1 is equal to 0, and then 1, 0 is equal to 0, and 1, 1 is equal to 1. So it means that both input must be 1 in order for the output X to be 1. So for NOR gate, it's quite simple. The output is just the opposite of input. And let's look at the table itself. So let's say we have 0 here, the output will be 1 since it's the opposite. And then let's say we have 1 here, the output will be 0, which is the opposite. So for NOR gate, this is a symbol. So if you look closely at this symbol, it looks exactly like the OR gate. It's just that it has an extra circle here. And let's look at how to make output equal to 1. So in order for the output to be 1, both inputs must be 0, which is exactly opposite of OR gate. And let's look at the table itself. So let's say we have 0, 0, we get 1. We get 0, 1, we get 0. We get 1, 0 equal to 0. We get 1, 1 equal to 0. It means that both of the input must be 0 in order to produce output equal to 1 for NOR gate, which is opposite of OR gate. Next we have NAND gate. So this is the symbol of NAND gate. So it looks exactly like AND gate. It's just that it has an extra circle here. So in order for the output to be 1, both inputs must not be 1, which is the opposite of AND gate. So let's look at the table example. So let's say that 0, 0 is equal to 1. 0, 1 equal to 1, 1, 0 equal to 1, and 1, 1 is equal to 0. So in order for the output to be 1, both input cannot be 1, which is exactly opposite of AND gate. Lastly, let's look at SOR gate. So this is a symbol of SOR gate with A, B, and out here. So in order for the out to be 1, one input is 1, and other input is 0. So let's look at the table itself. So we have 0, 0 is equal to 0, since either of the input is 0, so the output is 0. Then we have 0, 1 is equal to 1, and then 1, 0 equal to 1. And 1, 1 is actually equal to 0. So for SOR gate, one input must be 1 and the other input must be 0 in order to get output equal to 1. So we have covered different logic gates in this series. If you are interested to learn more topics about computer science, definitely just like the video and subscribe to the channel. And if you are taking Cambridge A-level computer science, definitely check out my upcoming online course at www.hagen.school. Thank you, and I see you again then. Bye bye.